appreciate all the love and positive stuff on my stage 2 review video. I'm gonna start this video with a little rant. Then we'll get into unboxing. So first of all, I wanna say, yeah, I live in the South now, but I'm originally born and raised in Northern California. And the way we came up is, if you're gonna put a bunch of money in your bike, in your car, or whatever, you're gonna put it in a motor. Motor's number one priority. All right, with that being said, if I wanted to go fast on a Harley, right? If I wanted to do some motor work, do the engine, and I spent 15, 20 grand, and I bought all Harley Davidson stuff, right? Spent 15, 20 grand just to get 120 horsepower out of it, y'all would laugh at me. Y'all would laugh me off the set. Y'all would say that was dumb money, right? But I feel like when it comes to the stereo and the audio stuff, that same type of thinking process isn't followed. I almost feel like people pride themselves in the more they spend, the ridiculously dumb amount of money that they spend is more kudos. Why isn't it the same? So what I'm setting out to do is upgrade my audio with some realistic budget stuff. I'm not gonna spend $4,000 on audio stuff. Gonna do a realistic budget. Gonna put some things together that, you know, most people can afford, and also, you know, see how it compares and what type of improvement we can get on the stock radio. Any improvement really is better when we're talking about, you know, doing a budget. Because it's not like these are bad, they're just not that loud. Especially when you got, you know, open exhaust with no baffles, no cat and all that kind of stuff. A little bit more sound. Plus, you know, then your pull-up game is tight. When you got the, you know, your music going and, you know, everybody's grooving and stuff, your pull-up game is on point there. But I got a partner that does audio installs and stuff like that. I'm gonna link his description, I'm gonna link his, probably his Facebook page in the description. He does lighting, he does stereos, he does alarms, he does auto starts on all types of vehicles, all that kind of stuff. So if you're in the, Northwest Louisiana area, hit him up, man. So I talked to him and I was thinking of budget-minded stuff. And this is what he came up with. He's done it all. He's installed from top end to bottom end as far as, you know, price spectrum goes. He's done it all. So I asked him what, on the low end of the budget end, you know, what I should be looking for quality-wise. And he directed me, you know, he suggested these, amongst others. These are the ones I decided on, but amongst others, he suggested these. Some SCAR audio. So without further ado, let's get into some unboxing and see what comes out. There's our audience today. Say hey. Anyway, that's my baby girl. Say hey, baby girl. That's Joe. Say hey, JoJo. Anyway, here we are. We've already kind of unwrapped it. And the goal here is to make an improvement over stock without breaking the bank. Do something comparable to a stage one or stage two boom audio kit, which I feel like I said, the culture is, if I spent $2,000 or $3,000 on a boom audio kit or Rockford Foskate or a Diamond audio setup, nobody would bat an eye. You know, even if I went and spent $20,000 on Harley Davidson motor parts, y'all would laugh at me. You know what I mean? So I'm kind of trying to take that concept and put it over to the audio side. Whereas I don't have to break the bank to get an improvement over stock and potentially sound just as good, or if not comparable to what you would spend too much money on other places. So the first thing we got here is SCAR Audio 6.5 Pro Audio Speakers. You guys can look these up. They're pretty popular, I guess. I really didn't know nothing about them, but they come covered up get a little manual in here, you know, several serial numbers. That's probably something we'll never even open up. Well, I guess we just did, but other than that, probably won't even look at this, right? So it came with a sticker. I gave it to my son. He likes stickers on everything. So here it is. There's a speaker. First things first. It's pretty heavy, pretty substantial, especially if we're talking about compared to a stock speaker. Let's take it out of this plastic here. Trying to do everything with one hand, so bear with me. So mark right here, 300 watt, 150 watt RMS. I'm not sure if we'll be putting, we're not gonna be putting 150 watts to it. I got a little four channel 400 watt kicker amplifier, compact amp, marine amp is gonna come in and power these bad boys. Probably run them in bridge and you know, I don't know if we'll be hitting that. We won't be hitting that 150 watts, but we'll get close to it, hopefully. You see a little nick there, tooling mark, whatever you want to call it. Got the four ohms, running four ohms. One thing I'll say I noticed is over a stock speaker is the strength here, a whole lot more solid. Whole lot more rigid, you know, all around more quality. Now at the same time, you gotta understand this ain't top of the line right here. This is not top of the line right here. But when you're talking about an improvement over stock, yes, this is that. All right, I don't know about y'all, but like I said, pretty average budget, pretty average goal. I'm not trying to enter any competition or anything. Just an improvement over stock. And so far, build and quality-wise and all that kind of stuff, we're hitting it. We're there so far. Obviously, you know, what the sound test does after that is we'll see. So, after that, so these are just mid-range speakers, all right? If you're running just a mid-range, then you're not gonna get the crisp highs and the clear voices and all that kind of stuff with just mid. So you have to understand that if you're not buying a coaxial speaker, you are going to need you some tweeters. All right, so I don't even know what that means, neodymium, whatever that says, but they tweeters, all right? Scar IO SPXT tweeters. And still got the sticker in here. It's pretty cool sticker. I don't think I'll stick it on nothing. Maybe the top of my bag or something like that. Maybe the top of my saddle bag or something. But you're not finna see this on the outside of my bike. I promise you that. Some more stuff we're not gonna read. So check these bad boys out. So I had the option of getting some more subdued ones that are black that would look more stock. But I actually like these. I like the way these stand out. I've seen the work done, and wait till you guys see how we do it on the bike, where they almost look like they were made to be on there, where you cut the hole in the stock speaker grill and stick these in, and it just pops, like, you know what I mean? Because the bike is all black, you got other different color tones going on, and boom, that sticks out at you, and I just like the way that looks. That's nice, huh? So let's go ahead and pull this out. And it's not lightweight, man. It don't feel like no flimsy stuff. This is, I want to say it's aluminum. You know what I mean? But it's a good feel. Here's the back of it. 400 watts RMS. 80 watts max. So if you look on the website, it's advertised at 80. And I want to say a whole lot higher. Max 360 or something like that. On the RMS and max. Y'all gotta understand, because there was even a review that said, oh, they're, when they came in the box, they were rated less than what they were advertised for. That's false advertisement. Nah, man, that's for the pair. You gotta double that up. So for the pair, you get 80 watts, but for each single one, it's 40 watts. Anyway, let's look at these. You can already see, like, some kind of, maybe some tooling marks, but this, some little fine scratches. But man, that stuff don't bother me, man. I ain't really nitpicky. Out here, we straight. I kind of like that Scar Audio. If you're a fan of labels, sticking that on there is pretty cool. But I'm pretty sure you can get that off of there if you wanted to. But I like that. I like that. Everything feels sturdy. The wires, they feel sturdy on there. You know, nice thick build quality. Not too flimsy on there. I can't wait to get it put in, man. And these little, let's say these little crossovers right here. You know, nothing too crazy about that. Unless you're like a super nerd, you really don't care about what's in this crossover anyway. So for a lot of super nerds out there, I'll pull this out. I'm not even sure what goes into this. I'm used to seeing the ones that have the coils inside. Well, I mean, there's a coil in there, I guess, but you know, it's got the different outputs, inputs that you actually screw on. The big square ones, you know what I'm trying to say, man. For all my super nerds out there, correct me down below in the comments of what, you know what I'm trying to say. But anyway, man, that's the unboxing portion. Next, hopefully we can get some video, if my boy don't mind, getting some video while we do the install and checking it out. And this is just for now. We're just gonna do the front speakers for now, mids and highs. So eventually we may add another small amp and do the 6x9s to add a little bit of bass on the bags. But you guys, hey, let me know if that's worth it. Like real talk, not advertisements or anything. I wanna hear from real people. Is it worth putting bags in a speaker? Losing a little bit of bag space. Is the sound quality even worth it? Y'all, let me know. Anyway, next thing you guys will see will be the install and hopefully a sound test.
Wonder this time.